So THAAD are acronyms for the Hookup Dinner. It's a community of entrepreneurs across Africa. Our vision is 1 million African entrepreneurs by 2025 that are solving problems, that are helping each other, that are trading across borders, and that are ensuring that we are not just making money, but we're moving Africa forward. Our goals are simple. If we can achieve even 1% of intra-Africa trade, it's a massive jump forward, because Africa, as much as we're such a small community of 1.2 billion people, our borders, we've got 52 countries in this continent. And if we can help South African entrepreneurs connect across the 52 different countries and help other African countries to connect into South Africa, then we are trading. And through trade, there's jobs, there's poverty that's being eradicated, there's inequality that's being eradicated, and unemployment is going down, especially youth unemployment. Why? Because we're the youngest nation in the world. Africans are younger than everybody else.
In terms of enterprise development, we've come from a position where it was a tick box exercise, but what has happened now is that there is more focus on actually having meaningful difference in developing SMEs that can make a difference in creating jobs. And I think that there is more that still needs to be done, but it's no longer the tick box exercise. It's far more now, more impactful than before. I think we need more corporates to come to these events, because I think there was more energy in the room, but pretty much the SMEs are hungry for business. I think SMEs need to be exposed to more opportunities that are in the corporate space. Secondly, we also need far more experienced entrepreneurs, that some of the young guys that are so that they could actually get opportunity to learn.
Okay, so I'm from a company called The People's Fund, and what we do is asset-backed crowdfunding as well as purchase order funding. So they need to have a contract with either government or corporate, and then we enable them to deliver to those people. So if they've got a contract or a purchase order, they come to us, we help them deliver to the actual client, and then we share in the proceeds of their growth. We fund people who are building real businesses, and people who have actually got a place in the market to actually execute. 51% black owned. We prefer women. They pay better and they're easier to work with.
Having pitched your idea tonight, how has the experience been, and was this your first time?
The experience was exotic in a way, because now it was my first time pitching my idea in a group of people. Yeah. So yeah, it was fun to do as well. Yeah.
And what do you hope the outcome to be?
I hope I win. Yeah, that's the outcome I'm hoping for. That's all.
Yeah. Yeah. And briefly explain to us, what's your business about?
Okay, I'm a property developer with the aim of becoming one of the biggest developers in Africa as a whole.
Génère de l'énergie en milieu rural pour ceux qui n'ont pas d'électricité, mais aussi pour ceux qui peuvent faire leur petit business, c'est-à-dire les petits tailleurs, les menuisiers, ainsi de suite.
Okay, Fatou Seshi is in the energy sector and involved in solar panels. So she wants to create a business that will provide electricity in the rural areas and to improve the lives of rural people with energy supply.
How did the idea Hook Up Dinner come about?
Well, it's all because of a need. To solve the entrepreneurial problems within the country. We're entrepreneurs that were part of the Richard Branson School of Entrepreneurship, and we realized that, you know, a lot of specifically black entrepreneurs were not meeting on a regular basis to give value with each other. I mean, look, there's a lot of networking platforms across the country, but we felt like, you know, how can we get like-minded entrepreneurs to be able to engage, connect, and contribute to each other's success?
Does that whole thing about, for instance, especially here, there's a whole lot of black entrepreneurs together. One of the things that you often see in social media is that blacks don't work together. That is not true, by the way, because the average black person is engaging with another black person. You don't see a lot of white people around you.